Hello everyone, good morning. Today we are going to see how to read the Robbins and Cottrell textbook of pathological diseases. You know, Robbins is the Bible of pathology for undergraduate students. But the textbook is written in a specific manner that most of the students feel a little bit difficult to approach the book, to remember what they have read, and the students are complaining that they forget the things very easily. So today in this video, I'm going to tell you how to get the maximum from the Robbins, how to utilize the maximum concepts from the Robbins, and how we can use that for your university examination as well as for our PG preparation. And some students have a habit of taking notes. And if so, for such students, let us see today how to take notes from that textbook of Robbins. You know, Robbins textbook, in each page, the author will wants to convey us that abundant information, not like the other textbooks, a piece of information, but an abundant information the author want to convey us. But as an undergraduate student, how we should remember those, that is what we are going to see today. So I hope that you will get the maximum benefit from this video, and let us go for the next. So this is a sample page I had copied from Robbins 10th edition, that to the chapter inflammation. So you know that this chapter inflammation is a part of what we call it as the general pathology. And in general pathology, we have some 8 to 9 chapters in Robbins. So for demonstration purpose, I have decided to take you a very easy chapter from the Robbins 10th edition, that is acute inflammation. So in this video, now I'm going to tell you how to read. Is it necessary to underline each and every points? How to remember these points? How we should reproduce in the exam? And how to utilize the maximum from this book so that we can even crack the questions for our PG preparation, PG entrance examinations also. You know, Robbins is the reference textbook for all the PG entrance exam. In our country, as well as even for foreign medical graduate examinations or for USMLE type of examinations, of course, Robbins is the reference textbook. So now I'm going to tell you how to start reading a chapter in Robbins. So you can see here the heading is acute inflammation. See, this book is written in a different manner. There are some letter which is mentioned as bold in here. You can see many letters are written bold in color. So, I will usually advise the students to take a note of these points. And remember, don't use multiple colors while underlining the points, because it is not for today, but after some 6 months or after some 1 year, when you are taking this textbook or this chapter again for your university examination, you should know whether these points are important or not. So I am against the opinion that it's not must to underline every point. And if you are having a habit of underlining each and every point, it will finally end up in trouble. You should know what are the key points you should get from this topic. So in acute inflammation, remember, the acute inflammation has three major components: a dilation of vessels, following permeability, and finally emigration. So suppose acute inflammation has been asked as a short note question, it is these key points you should remember at first. Fine? Yes. And then the author wants to give a brief idea about what he is going to tell in the next subsequent paragraphs. So these points are not at all important for us. So there is nothing to underline in this paragraph. Then coming into the next heading, reaction of blood vessels in acute inflammation. And children, a very important point what you have to take note of is about the pictures. See, Robbins pictures are very, very important. It is these pictures which will finally help you. It is this picture which finally will help you to remember the exam or write the exam. It is these pictures which is very, very important. And I know that most of the students will neglect these pictures. Try to remember this picture. Fine. See, the author here wants to convey you what is the differences between an exudate and what is the features of a transudate. What is the difference between it? This picture itself is self-explanatory. Remember, unlike the other textbooks you are following in other subjects, Robin's textbook, the pictures are self-explanatory. If you draw this picture for your exam, that itself can explain what you want to convey to the examiner. So what I want to tell you is, please focus on these pictures. Okay, that is the another key point what I have to tell you. Very important point. Focus on the pictures. These pictures plays a very, very important role. And then coming into the reactions of blood vessels in acute inflammation. See how you have to go through. As I have told already, you have to, of course, underline this bold letters, because these bold letters are only the key points the author want to tell you in this section. Then he has already is going to explain what is exudate and what is transudate. See, exudate, transudate, the same thing he has already conveyed in these pictures. So whenever there is a picture and the corresponding thing the author is explaining in paragraphs, always go for the picture, because it is this picture. Visual memory is, you know, always predominant, and that only will always help you rather than going for the other memories, that is the auditory memories, everything. It is a visual memory which helps you the most. And what you are reading, no, it won't, you will forget after some 1 week or something. And then the author wants to tell you what are the changes in the vascular blood flow. See, the first point, see this bullet points, no, these are important. Don't underline each and every line, it won't help you. Just underline vasodilation. Vasodilation, why the vasodilation is occurring? It is due to the several mediators, notably histamine. So just underline histamine. Just underline histamine. Histamine is the only word you have to underline in this para. Then, because of this vasodilation, why it is happening, or what is the consequence of this? Increased permeability of the microvasculature. And after that, what will happen? There will be loss of fluid. Finally, we have a condition called stasis. So these are the key points. Don't underline each and everything. So just me, let me tell once again, how, what all things you are going to note down in this picture, in this page. Okay, this is a Robin's 10th edition. In this page, what at the end of the reading, at the end of reading. See, Robin's reading, we have two phases. Phase 1, phase 2. Phase 1, you are going to read like a storybook. And in phase 2, you are going to read only the key points what you are going to underline. Let me tell what are the color codes you should follow while reading. See, before going to that, please just remember this color code. Yellow, key ideas. That means I have told in Robin's already. See, this is just what I am following, and you can change accordingly, but don't use more than 3 colors, okay? Because it will make the textbook difficult to read again once you take that book. So make the books very clear. Don't underline each and every point, so that days before the examination, you itself will feel irritated for reading this. So these are the color code what I follow in my Robins. Yellow, use key ideas. Yellow color, or you can use orange or something like that for key ideas. That means the important things. Red for direct cords. Direct cords means facts. I have told you, right? Vasodilation due to histamine, which finally leads to microvasculature, increased permeability, finally stasis. These are the keywords. And blue for definition. What is inflammation? What is neoplasia? The author has his own definition for these terminologies. This definition means it is going to define those words, and you cannot change this and write as whatever you like. So these definition you should follow. And some, there are some cases where you can go for another color code also, particularly green. And what is the importance of green means? Green you have to use for the concepts you will forget. F-O-R-G-E-T, remember. There are some points in Robin's that is like the markers. You know, for example, in inflammation, you will have CD31, CD62, E-selectin, P-selectin, so and so. So those things, no, these are very tiny things which you will get forget. So those things you can underline using green, but maximum remember, use only 3 color codes. Fine? Yes. So this is how you should, all these things comes under phase 1 reading Robin's. That means for the first time you are taking this chapter, you are reading so and so. Fine, then only you have to don't do any things in phase 2 reading, because in phase 2 reading what you are going to do, you are going to just go through the important points and all these color codes what you have marked during your phase 1. Fine, yes. So at the end of this, in this page, what are all you going to note down? Just I'm going to mention that only. You have to underline acute inflammation. These bold letters you have to underline for sure. Then reactions of blood vessels in acute inflammation. This is the first point. For example, I have told you acute inflammation, when it is asked in a university exam as a short note or an essay question, you should know, right, how to write the key points. See, this is the first point you have to write. Then in that first point, you write this changes in vascular flow as a sub point. Take it as this is 1 and this is A. Fine, this is how you have to write. And then this picture, suppose if they asked for some 1 mark or 2 mark, what is exudate and transudate, you can what code this also. Fine, yes. And this point you have to write key points, vasodilation, histamine, microvasculature, increased permeability and stasis. So now I have underlined all these points. I have underlined all these points. This is vasodilation, increased permeability of vasculature, stasis, everything I have underlined. So this is my phase 1 reading of Robbins. What I am going to do when I am reading it for the second time, that is phase 2. I will just read these points only. I will just read these points. And remember, whenever you are reading the Robbins again, always focus on pictures. Pictures are the most important. Pictures, very, very important, most important. They are the VIP persons. You should focus, because it is these pictures only which will give you hints during the examination for writing your short notes or something. And as you all know, all the PG entrance examinations are based on this image based questions. It's a new type of questions. So you can answer all those when you remember these pictures. Fine? Yes. Next, what I would like to tell you, suppose if you have a habit of taking notes, it is very difficult to note each and every point, because if you start doing like that, you can even publish your own Robbins after 1 year. So it is not usually practically possible. If you start taking note now, please do that till the end. Don't break it up at the midterm. Okay, it won't work. So if you are taking notes, you can take the notes within the textbook itself. In this, I am going to tell how is it possible. You have something what we call it as sticky notes. Am I right? You have something what we call it as sticky notes. I used to take notes on sticky notes only. You can paste that note at the upper or the lower corner of your Robbins page. And in that, what all things you have to note down. Don't try to write everything. Again, what are the things you have to remember? Yeah, this page I will tell you. Yes, so you can take the notes, okay, and you can paste it over the upper or over the lower corner, okay, yes, or you can paste it anywhere. There is no specific position for it. You can paste it anywhere. How you are going to take it? Here, see, in this page, what the author wants to convey, the author wants to tell about how the leukocytes are attached to the endothelial cells. Fine. Here we are having some two component called selectins and integrins. I have already told you these are the CD62E, CD31, CD11, CD49, all those things. So these are the things which we will forget. So I already tell you, you can use the better color code green for those things which we will forget easily from the Robbins. And as a result of this, so you may underline this. Okay, you are going to underline these important points with the green color, okay, with the green color, and selectins, integrins, ICAM, VCAM, so and so, all these you are going to, Weibel palate granules, okay, in platelets, everything. So all these you are going to underline with the green color. That's what you have to do first. Then if you have a habit of taking notes, I have told, right, you have something called a sticky notes. You can paste it over the upper or lower right corner. In that, you are going to write just the key points, what you will forget, or Suppose if the examiner in exams asks you write about selectins and integrins for 2-mark question or any MCQ questions, if you want to answer, these key points are very, very important. So in that sticky note, you are going to just mention what EPL selectin. Their marker is CD62. CD is a marker. CD stands for cluster of differentiation. Okay, it's a CD marker. So what is the importance of the CD marker? It is using this marker we are going to detect. Okay, we have a lot of techniques you will learn very soon. We call it as IHC, immunohistochemistry. Okay, using that technique, we'll be able to detect these mediators like selectins, integrins, and so using these markers. We'll release an antibody which is targeted against this marker, then which will be combining with a fluorescent compound which will emitting in color, so. Okay, you go and read about IHC. So you are going to just note down in sticky notes in this page. As far as this page is concerned, you are going to just mention E selectin, L selectin, and P selectin. And for CD31 IgG, remember, in Robbins, not at all. It is not possible to remember each and every points. And remember, all points are not important. You should know what points you have to focus. For example, consider this table, children. Consider this table. In that, the only thing we want to know is E selectin, L selectin, P selectin, and where they are located. These things are not at all needed. If you read, if you are reading this also, I will only consider it as a waste memory, because you are going to forget that very soon, and this is not going to help you in attending any of the examinations. Even in university, they will don't ask. Even in any PG entrance exam, they won't ask anything. Fine. So that is why I told it's a waste memory. But you should remember these three: E selectin, L selectin, P selectin, this is their location. Fine. This is just an example. This is just an example of, I have to tell you. Then, so that is the another thing what I want to tell you about those regarding it. Then what I want to tell you next is how to focus on the pictures. Okay, so first I have told you how to approach start reading Robbins. Second, I have told you how to take notes. Third, I have told you underline the important points. And the last thing, color coding, I have told you. And last thing, how to approach the pictures. I have told you it is the pictures, visual memory, which will helps you to remember, which will give you the hints during your examination. And hence, I would like to tell you now how to approach the pictures in Robbins. Okay, yes, let us discuss that in a little bit of detail. So this is a picture of leukocyte migration. Remember, leukocyte migration is a key event of acute inflammation. And in that, this is of course a standard university short note question, or you may get multiple questions in your PG entrance also. So how to remember with this picture itself, you can remember the entire event. See how beautifully the author is explaining what happens to the leukocyte, how they are attaching to the sialyl Lewy 6 modified glycoprotein, about the role of integrin, selectin, cytokines, chemokine. I would like you to just remember these key points. Remember this like a flow chart. If you are going to paste, suppose if you have any plan of pasting a sticky note here in this page, what is the only thing you are going to, in the form of a small flowchart, you are going to describe this entire events. This is what you are going to do in this page. You are not going to underline even anything. Okay, see, margination, rolling, adhesion. Okay, if you want, you can underline these points. But rather than this picture is what I call it as self-explanatory. This picture itself can explain the whole thing. So that is a unique feature of Robbins textbook, and the students will neglect to consider this. They will think that this picture is a little bit complicated. No, all pictures are very easy. You can note down, you can make it a little bit more easier by taking sticky notes. Sticky notes means you don't need that. You can even take a piece of A4 size paper, cut it into small pieces, and you can paste it over here. Of course, children, it is this sticky notes, it is this important points what you're highlighting you are going to write in exam. Okay, because today you will underline each and every line. The next day you will forget 50% of it. On the day of examination, you won't write anything. Your memory will be 0%. You can't remember this. Okay, so this is a smart way of remembering robins. I have been doing this for the last 1.5 years. And of course, that only yield a very great results. And still today, I'm able to remember each and every point. Key points. Fine? Yes. So, if you have any plan of doing sticky notes, you just convert this picture into flowcharts and you can write it down here. Fine. This is how you should approach robins, and remember the color coding. So, robins is the Bible of pathology. It is a must to read book. If you have time or not, you should read robins. Robins is called as the Bible of pathology. You should read this robins for sure sake. Sure sake, you should read robins, no doubt. So how to read it, I have told you, and hope this video will be useful. And if you have any doubts, please you can ask me. Okay, so all the best. Smart reading will only help us remember the right things. Fine. Always we should have, how much quantity we read doesn't matter. How we read a page, that is going to matter. Thank you. Thank you very much.